Good afternoon, everybody. I have to firstly thank the EAN eBrains Joint Workshop Organization for the kind invitation and also the chairman's. This presentation will focus on the EAN scientific panel of stroke and particularly on the aims, roles, and activities of the panel. Regarding the aims and the field of interest of the panel, the first aim is to prioritize stroke research and disseminate evidence-based treatments within European countries, especially developing countries. And key clinical and research areas include the acute management of ischemic and hemorrhagic stroke, but also the management of cerebrovascular disease, including the diagnostic workup and secondary prevention strategies. The panel is not only interested in clinical management and therapies, but also in neuroimaging, lab, and genetic investigation. Within the EAN, the panel specifically has to promote issues related to cerebrovascular diseases and educational and scientific activities within the framework of the EAN. And the panel includes members representative from all European countries and contribute usually to the development of the scientific program at EAN conferences and to the implementation of other educational activities. And the panel is encouraged to develop clinical guidelines and collaboration with other European medical associations, including the European Stroke Organization and the European Society of Cardiology, are encouraged. The panel also contributes to the update of EAN website and EAN pages in the field of cerebrovascular diseases. And young stroke neurologists are particularly encouraged to take part to the scientific panel of stroke. Regarding the core composition of the Stroke Scientific Panel. The management group is composed by two co-chairs, three members, and one ESO representative, and one representative of the resident fellow group. These are the two co-chairs, me and Nathan Bornstein. And this is the stroke management group, and as you can see, several countries are represented in the group: Israel, Italy, Germany, Serbia, Norway, UK, and Portugal. And in the management group, as we told before, are included L. Charlotte Sanset, that is the ESO representative from Norway, and Diana de Aguiar de Sousa from Portugal, that is the representative of the resident fellow within the Stroke Scientific Panel. The Stroke Scientific Panel is also composed by other members, and particularly by 38 individual panel members, six resident fellow members, two patient representatives, 52 institutional panel members, three partner societies representatives, two representatives of stroke in the stroke panel in the panel of rare neurological disease, and one liaison officer. Regarding the three partner society representatives, they are Hamidon Basri from Malaysia, who is representative of the Asian Ocean Association of Neurology, Marja Sterling from Switzerland, who is representative of the European Pediatric Neurology Society, And finally, as Charlotte Sunset, as we told before, from Norway, and she is the representative of the European Stroke Organization within the Stroke Scientific Panel, EAN. The two representatives of the Stroke Scientific Panel within the Panel of the Rare Neurological Disease are Anita Arsovska and Georgos Tsigouris. And finally, the liaison officer of Stroke Scientific Panel is Les Didier from France. He is the editor-in-chief of European Journal of Neurology, that is the journal of European Academy of Neurology. And the aim of the liaison officer is to link the Stroke Scientific Panel to EAN committees and board. Regarding the activities of the Stroke Scientific Panel, they are listed in this slide, and they range from Congress preparation to e-communication that includes neurology updates, scales and score, milestone in neurology, and also reports from the activity of the panel, but also guideline production and educational activities. These tasks were distributed among the participants to the Stroke Scientific Panel, trying to maintain an equal distribution among different countries, including the developing countries. The first important activity of the Stroke Scientific Panel is the organization of EAN meeting, and they contribute, the scientific contribute to the program. And as you can see, an example, that is the last EAN conferences of 2021. And as you can see, the panel contributed with two teaching courses, two workshop, two interactive session, and two joint symposium. And the cerebrovascular disease were also represented in two oral presentation, two e-presentation, and six e-poster. Another encouraged activity is the production of guidelines or consensus papers. And in the last years, the panel produced a joint guideline in collaboration with the ESO on post-stroke cognitive impairment, and another joint guideline on pharmacological support in early motor rehabilitation after stroke, and produced also an EAN consensus paper on monogenic cerebral small vessel disease diagnosis and therapy that was recently published on a European Journal of Neurology. The EAN and Stroke Scientific Panel is also involved in review and survey activities, and particularly in review for EAN fellowship, and also in the preparation of vignette for the European Board of Neurology Examination, and is also involved in some endorsement of papers and of regional teaching courses, and is also involved in the approval of speakers. Another important task is the update of e-pages. This task was attributed to Simon Fandler-Hoffler and to Milija Miljajovic, and for instance, the update was to include a study on stroke and COVID-19, to include a report on the TAIL study on double anti-aggregation for mild stroke or TIA, and a report on direct MT study on mechanical thrombectomy in association with intravenous thrombolysis. Also, a statement on COVID-19 was also reported and reported on the EAN website during 2020. Another activity is also to report and update the scales and score that are applied in cerebrovascular disease. And these scales now include NIH and the modified ranking scale and other scales, but was recently updated with the modified treatment in cerebral ischemia scale. And regarding scores, the Alberta Stroke Program Early CT score, that is ASPECTS, that is applied for acute stroke, was also recently included. Another important activity that is highly encouraged by EIN is the cooperation with other societies, and particularly the ESO. We saw before that we have a representative of ESO within the panel, but also joint guidelines with the ESO are encouraged, as well as a joint symposia, as we reported for the last virtual congress, one joint symposium at the EIN conference on recent advances in acute stroke pathophysiology and treatment, and also there was a joint session ESO-ENN at ESOC conference on current status of on the diagnosis and management of intracranial stenosis. Another collaboration ongoing is with the European Society of Cardiology, and Nathan Bornstein is the representative member of the EIN Stroke Scientific Panel at the Stroke Council Board of the European Society of Cardiology. This is only the example of the joint section we had ESO and the EIN that we had at the last EIN conference, reporting recent advances in acute stroke pathophysiology and treatment. Regarding the future stroke scientific panel plans, surely it will continue to collaborate with other societies like ESO, with a representative members, but also with the involvement in ESO Educational Committee. Before, Hugh Marcus was a representative of the EIN Scientific Panel, and in the next years I will represent the EIN at the ESO Education Committee. And also we hope to develop a joint guidelines supported by the group represented by Mauro Leone at EIN and the group of Guillaume Turk, Simona Sacco and Giorgos Tsigouris of ESO. And also we hope to develop a joint session both at EIN and ESOC conferences. We hope that our collaboration with the European Society of Cardiology will continue, and we hope also to continue the collaboration with other scientific panels, as the rare neurological disorders, but we hope also to encourage collaboration with the neurosonology group, neurorehabilitation and dementia. The other activities that the panel will continue are the contribution to the EIN pages, the submission of proposal for a scientific program of the next EIN conferences, and also the contribution to various stroke-related educational activities of the EIN, like Springer and Summer School. Finally, if we analyze what is still lacking for the stroke scientific panel, for sure, clinical and research data sharing in cerebrovascular disease among European countries is still lacking. These lead to studies with a small sample size and the research and studies conducted locally in single center of our lab, and often study and research duplication. There is also a lack of a standardized harmonization among the global research community in the cerebrovascular disease field, so, and particularly in clinical and neurological neuroradiological data acquisition, there are no standardized criteria. It leads to research with heterogeneous data and often non-comparable. And also we observe also a still poor collaboration among the stroke scientific societies and scientists, and also a poor exchange among the scientific panels within the EAN. This lead to an exploited research and the massive amount of data that are not useful for to improve our knowledge and to understand the brain disease. If the question is, does an informatic support can an informatic support be useful to improve these aspects, and can an external support, as Abrahams could suggest, help to cover this gap? This is a good question, and probably it is useful to try and to make some pilot studies to observe if this gap can be covered. I thank you so much, and thank you also from the EAN Stroke Scientific Panel.